Hello students, welcome to today's session. This is Shweta Roy, your English Master Teacher at Vedantu. And today I'm going to start with the session solving the sample paper. But of course, as you know that this is a long, you know, the paper is quite long, so it cannot be done in one session. So as I told you in the previous session where I showed you the sample paper that we will be dividing this into two sessions. So in today's session, we will be solving, as I told you that you also solve in your home, right? The sample paper, do solve it so that you can give me the answers, right? So today we will be solving the literature portion and the grammar portion. And in the next part, we will be taking care of the reading and the writing part. So that sounds great, doesn't it? Yes or no, guys? Okay, so let me quickly see who all are present with us today. One second. I cannot see the students. One second. Why can't I see the students? One second, guys. Let me check. All right, so yes, hi Krishna, hi Jessica, hi Ananya, hi Mithilesh, hi Sarika, hi Jessica, hi Atul, hi Arvind. So guys, a doubt is screaming in my ears. Okay, Arvind, pure Vedan, please tell me your doubt so that I can solve it right now, right here. Hi Om, hello Aman. Okay, so now let us start with the session. Without further ado, I hope all of you are super duper excited to see, look into the solution of the sample paper. Yes or no? Arre, thank you, Joseph. Thank you so much. So, the portions that we have still not covered, that we are going to do when we will be dealing with that particular chapter. Okay, so I have excluded those questions which are from those chapters which we are still left. Okay, so don't worry, when I will be covering those particular chapters, I will be taking up these questions which has been asked in the question paper, in the sample paper pertaining to that particular chapter. So don't worry, don't think that I am excluding or missing out something. All right, so that is why I am starting with the question from, I mean, this particular chapter, which particular chapter is this extract taken? Anyone? Hi, Himani. So quickly tell me, the baker or the bread seller of those days, from which chapter has this extract been taken? Quickly tell me. So you all are going to answer. You have to participate in the discussion. That is why I told you that first you need to solve. Okay? Baker from Goa. Very good, Mega Mind. Amazing. All right. So this extract, I hope you have already read the extract. So let me go to the question directly. So what is the question asked? This is the picture that is given to you and you have to choose the answer that lists the correct option. So anybody, what is the question? Recording of the baker's monthly account. So how did the baker record his monthly accounts? Option you can see. So what is the option here? You can see from the picture, it is notebook. Next option is palms of your hand, right? Next one is wall and the next one is in mind. So what do you think? Which is the correct answer? Option number three. Okay, let us have a look. Absolutely correct. So the baker used to record his monthly account on wall. Very good. Very well answered. Amazing. Okay guys, so before proceeding with the session further, a gentle reminder to those of you who have still not subscribed. So guys, what we have seen is people are facing so many difficulties, especially in this time of pandemic. And, they are facing so many doubts. And we, even in normal situation without pandemic, still the students face so many doubts, right? So many problems you have, and the doubts being the most important ones, right? So you do not have proper channels. So as most of you are saying that I have so many doubts, ma'am, doubt is screaming loudly in my ear, right? So that is the problem, and you do not have proper channel to actually solve all your doubts, right? So notes, the unavailability of notes being the second important problem that students usually face. As a result of which, what happens, the assignments that they get, either they are not getting an assignment. So if they are not getting an assignment, then their revision becomes incomplete. And if they are getting the assignment, they are not able to solve because of the unavailability of notes and the not their doubts not being cleared, right? Tests, as a result, they lag behind in their tests, right? Competitive exams also, they lack guidance in that. Choice of schedule, choice of language being the other major problems that you usually face. So don't worry, guys, because we in our platform have come up with all the solution of all your problems. So doubts, you will no longer face any doubts because we have proper channel, right? Kaise, how? We have class teachers as well as master teachers, right? So the entire team of class teacher is only and only there to solve all your doubts, right? Along with master teachers, of course. So you can see that here you are getting in-class doubt solving instantaneously and live, right? Isn't that amazing? Notes you are going to get after each and every session, assignment after each and every session. Tests, we do conduct monthly tests. We do conduct tests which are the performance report of which we also do provide you. And on the basis of which what happens is you will be able to understand where you stand exactly. Apart from that, you also have competitive exams, which we take care of, various Olympiads, and all this in your selected time slot in your language, guys. So, and we also have some amazing bonus features like micro course, which is chapter wise course, and so that is constantly going to fill up all your gaps, whatever gap is left. You know, if you have any problem in any particular chapter, you can avail the micro course of that particular chapter for free only with this one subscription. All these features are there for you. Crash course enables you for complete revision. Apart from that, we have performance report, and the most important thing which is not there in YouTube is personalized attention, which we cannot of course give you in YouTube, but of course that is possible in the in our platform, guys. So personalized attention is very important, and what you need to do is just visit the link in the description box and pinned comment, choose your grade, choose your board, select the, check out all the details, and finally click on get subscription. After this, what you can do is three types of subscription you have: 1 month, 3 months, and 6 months. And if you ask me, I would recommend the 6 month subscription because there you end up paying less than what you pay each month, and 6 months is a standard duration that you require, right? And don't forget to use the coupon code SWREPRO. Okay, so do avail this. This is for the English channel, is SWREPRO. All right, guys, so do not forget to use the coupon code SWREPRO in order to avail the discount. So for your channel, guys, this is the coupon code. There is a mistake here. It should be SWREPRO. All right, guys. Okay, hi. Meghna, hi Krishna. Hi Sakshi. All right, so now we will resume our session. And resuming our session, you have to give me the answer for the next one. When the writer says baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days, he means that what should be the correct option? Quickly tell me. Quickly tell me. I'm waiting for your answer. Jaldi, jaldi, jaldi. Good afternoon, Vinita. Quickly tell me. Question number two. Whoever will give me the answer, I will take the name of that particular student. Come on. Anant is saying A. Anybody else? Nivedita is saying C, okay? So there is a confusion I could see between A and C. Don't worry, I'm going to clarify that confusion. Okay, first of all, let us solve this, the next one, and then I will give you the answer to both. Next is, the statement that is true about payment collection according to the passage is, quickly tell me, what is the answer for the next one? A, B, C, D. Next one. Most of you are saying D. Okay, let's go to the answer. So the first answer would be, the correct answer would be C. See, read the sentence. Baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days. So what is it talking about? Profession. It's talking about the profession, right? And in the old days. So in the old days, baking was profitable. So profession was profitable. And what is your first option? Baking isn't as popular in Goa currently. It's not about popularity. There is no mention of popularity here, right? So baking as a job is profession. So here it was talking about profession. So the correct answer would be C. I hope you get it clear. Next is B. Okay, what is the question? 1 minute. All right. The statement that is true about the passage is the baker was paid for his services at the end of the month. Yes, it's not D. At the end of the month, he was paid. The baker was paid for his services at the end of the month. It's not at in any day. No, it's only at the end of the month that is mentioned in the text. So that requires a careful reading of the text. All right? Okay. So next one is the kabai was a peculiar outfit. Come on, this one. Fourth, whoever will give me the answer, I will take the name. It's not very tough, dear. Try to understand. It's very simple. At least the literature part is very simple. Come on. B. Okay. You are saying B. Most of you are saying B. Okay. Let's see. Next one. The extract uses the phrase invites the comments. Which of the following expression is incorrect with respect to the word invites? Question number 5. Option. Come on, quickly tell me. Question number five. Option two. Prayers. Okay, Megamind is saying option two. Fine, let us find out the correct answer. So the first one, you all were correct. The peculiar outfit was a dress-like material, of course. It was a dress-like material. And there is a difficulty in understanding, I think, in the fifth question. Don't worry. Going to explain it to you. Now see, you can invite trouble. Inviting trouble is fine. Okay. You can invite application, right? You can invite guests, but can you invite prayers? No. So prayer here is the odd one out. So that is what you have to do. You have to select the odd one out in relation to the word invite. So inviting trouble is fine. Inviting application is also okay. Inviting guests is also perfectly correct. But inviting prayer is not, I mean, it's the odd one out, right? So that is the answer. Hi, Shubham. Thank you. Okay, thank you, God of Thunder. Thank you so much. Okay, guys. So yes, I really request you to kindly subscribe to the English channel if you still haven't done so. Please do share your love just as you have done in the other channel, right? And then we have the extract-based question, the next extract. So quickly first tell me what is the meaning, from where has this stanza been extracted? Hi, Surikan. Thank you, Seema. Quickly tell me, from where is this taken? Tiger in the zoo? Amazing. The fact that the tiger is stalking the length of the cage tells us that he is restless. Come on, which is the correct option? Which is the correct option? Quickly tell me. Number one. Okay. A. Most of you are saying A. Chalo, let us see. Absolutely correct. The tiger is restless. Now, here I would give you one homework. One homework for you is, you have to find out, this is your homework, you have to find out the meaning of all the other words. Okay, meaning. And you have to find, you have to make sentences. Okay, do comment the answer in the comment section, right? What you have to do is find out the meaning of these three words and also make sentences with them, and that, and post your answers in the comment section. Would you do that? This will be really helpful in enhancing your vocabulary. Okay, so please do this. This is your homework, finding out the meaning and making sentences with these particular words. Do post your comments in the comment section. I would take up your comments for the next session. All right. Next. rhyme scheme of the given stanza. Quickly tell me, what is the rhyme scheme? Hi, Ashka, of course, I do remember you. D? Okay, some of you are saying D. Let us see. Okay, question number 3. These stanzas bring out the contrast between question number 3. Thank you, Rishabh. Question number 3. Thor is saying C. Okay. What is the caged tiger not likely to say to the visitor? What is he not likely to say? Question number 4. Krishna is saying B. Fine. Okay. Next is the tiger's brilliant eyes reveal that. Question number 5. Come on, question number 5. Question number 5. Are thank you, Jatin. Anyone? A. Okay, Diya is saying A. Okay, let's have a look whether you all are correct or not. So these are the answers. Okay, let me explain you the rhyme scheme first. Rhyme scheme is A, B, C, B, A, B, C, B. Let me go back to the stanza. C. His strength behind bars. Let us take it as A. Stalking the length of his cage. So this is not rhyming with this. So let us take it as B. Ignoring visitors. Again not rhyming. C. He hears the... Okay. Yehi tha kya? One second. Sorry. Ye wala tha na. This was the... passage. This was the stanza. I'm really sorry. See, his strength behind bars is A. Stalking the length of his cage is B. So, this is C. And again, A, B, C, B, hai na? A, B, C, B. Yes. Okay, so that is the correct answer. The line above is the first line. Which one? Ek minute. There is some confusion in this one. One second. A, B, C. This and this is rhyming. Visitors. Okay, this should be A, B, bars and visitors are rhyming, right? A, B, A, C hona chahiye. One second, I think I am also getting confused in this. Achha, isko hum thoda baad mein karenge. This is a little bit confusing. Okay, moving ahead, we will solve this a little later. Okay, moving ahead, freedom and captivity toh bahut hi simple hai. Okay, this question. Why? What is the caged tiger not likely to say to the visitor? That means, caged tiger, what it cannot say to the visitor? Okay, what it can say is, stop staring. What is going on in his mind is, of course, stop staring. And it could also say, set me free. Of course, these are the ideas that is going on in his mind. Go away. That is also possible. But of course, he is not anyhow saying, join me. He cannot anyhow say, join me. Right? Yes or no? Okay. Hi, Ankit. Alright. So, next is the tiger's brilliant eyes. Okay. This is also an important question because most of you got confused, I think, between A and C, right? So, the tiger's brilliant eyes reveal that he hopes to be free in the wild. So, that is what he was thinking. When he was looking at the stars with his brilliant eyes, he was hoping rather than enjoying the bright stars. Of course, he was enjoying. And why was he enjoying? Because the stars were the only connect between his homeland and his now and his present artificial existence, right? So that is why what he longed for was only and only he longed to go back to the wild and carefree atmosphere that he had. So that is why the first option is the correct one. Okay? Alright. Hi, Shraddha. एबीसीबी. हां जी बेटा, एबीसीबी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू. थोड़ा सा आई एम ऑल्सो गेटिंग कंफ्यूज. आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अ लिटिल लेटर. ओके, सो बिफोर दैट वी विल आई एम रियली वेरी हैप्पी एंड इलेटेड टू अनाउंस दैट Vedantu students have bagged top ranks in IIT JEE. Okay, so let us celebrate the success of our wonderful students and our superheroes and get motivated, get inspired by all of them, because if they can, then we can as well, right? So that is what is important for us, to get motivated and to do our best. Yes? Okay. There is a line which I skipped. He is locked in a concrete cell. Acha, that is why maybe error ho raha tha na. I will just go back and see what I had skipped. Theek hai, because otherwise it will take up much of the time. If I keep on trying to rectify that, it will take up. So whatever is the confusion, I will clear it out in the maybe next class. Don't worry. Maybe there was an error or something. I skipped one line. Don't worry. I will be rectifying that and I will be clearing that in the next class. Otherwise, it will take up the entire class, right? Okay. So moving ahead with the next stanza. This is from which poem? Please tell me. This is from which poem? Ball poem. Thank you, Shubham. Okay, so this is from the ball poem. All right, very good, absolutely correct. And the question is, the poet uses the ball as a symbol of the boys. Very simple. Come on, quickly tell me. Ankit, hi. Jaldi se batao, quickly. Which is the correct option? B. Okay. Next one. The poet feels that there is no point in consoling the boy. Quickly tell me. Hi, Ashka. I'm good. Next one. Next one. Question number two. Come on. First line I have missed. I told you that I will check. I will check that, dear. D. Okay, most of you are saying D. Very good. Absolutely correct. The ball is the symbol of the boy's carefree childhood days, right? So they are related to each other. And the boy, when he is losing the ball, he is at the same time losing his carefree childhood days, because the ball is bringing, I mean, the ball, with the ball, he was associating all his childhood memories, right? So both of them are interrelated to each other. And his childhood is also, when I was teaching you this poem, I told you that along with the loss of the ball is also the loss of the childhood, the innocent childhood. And now he is, he is taking a step further and stepping into the world of experience, right? So innocence is lost, but loss and gain, they are the two sides of the same coin, right? Because if he is losing something, he is gaining something else as well. What is that gain? That is experience, right? So that is the question, that is the answer. And the next one is, whatever he has lost is irretrievable, right? So no amount of money, nothing can console the boy. Why? Because whatever he has lost forever. Because it's not just about the materialistic ball. It is about the emotions with which he was connected to the ball, right? So that cannot be brought back, because the same ball which has been lost, it cannot be brought back, right? So that is the correct answer. Next, the word harbor does not have a meaning similar to. That means which word does not mean the same as harbor? You have to select the odd one out from here. Quickly tell me the answer. Are Amritam, there is nothing to be anxious. There is nothing to be anxious. Just enjoy. Okay? Enjoy and seek interest in your subject. You will see. Don't think about the exams. Don't think about the results. Just perform your task. If you see that you're performing your task, you will find success automatically. You will be doing very good. I'm sure about that. Okay? D. Okay, most of you are saying D. Very good. Let's see what is the next question. Merrily over there, it is in the water. The dash here is meant to convey. Quickly tell me. Fourth wala. Fourth. C. Okay, most of you are saying C. Let's see. The word that does not indicate a physical manifestation of sorrow is. That means physical manifestation. When you become sorrowful, what is not physically manifested out of these words? Worthless, shaking, trembling, rigid. Quickly. A? Okay. Let us find out the answers. Alright, cargo is the correct answer. And now I would suggest you to find out the meaning. Okay, this is just one word. Quickly tell me what is the meaning of the word cargo. Anyone of you would be able to tell me. And the meaning of the word harbor. Harbor and cargo. Please find out the meaning quickly and let me know right now. Thank you, Gopika. Cargo means goods. Absolutely correct. And what is the meaning of harbor? What is the meaning of harbor? Yes, goods that could be transported in the ship, that is cargo. Absolutely correct. Harbor is dock. Okay, port. Very good. That means where the ships take shelter. That is harbor. Port, similar to port. All these are synonyms. Okay. Sorry. Okay, next is merrily over the dash. Merrily over dash. There it is in the water. Some thoughtful moments. I think this is the correct answer. As far as Iskiliad, I have to go through the poem once more. Okay. But as far as I think, this should be some thoughtful moment. Unexpected interruption. There is a confusion between these two options, right? A sense of unexpected interruptions. I will have to check the poem once more and I will let you know. Okay? Till then, what do you think? Should it be C or should it be D? Should it be C or should it be D? What do you think? Let us solve. It should be C. You think it's a sense of unexpected interruption, but at this time, no one was interrupted. No one was interrupting, no? Okay, let me read the poem. Let me read the poem and I will let you the answer. Do comment in this regarding this answer in the comment section. What do you think? And I will let you know in the next class. Okay? So, moving ahead is the next one. That is worthless. I got confused between C and D. So, no issues. I will go through the poem because I actually did not get enough time to solve the entire paper. So, anyways, I will just check the poem once again and let you know. Okay, worthless. Worthless is the correct answer. Because see, when you are sorrowful, you can be shaking. That is again a physical manifestation, right? That is a bodily movement. So all these are bodily movements, but worthless is not a bodily movement. So worthless would be the correct answer. Why cargo? Because as I told you, that cargo means the goods that you carry, which is not similar to harbor. Harbor means it's a place where the ships take shelter. Like the port, pier, dock, these are all synonyms, but cargo is something which is different. Okay? Meaning of pier, same as harbor, dear. Same as harbor. Vedantu Pro subscription, beta, go to the description box, check the link there, and you will find the steps. Alright? You will find choose your grade, choose your board. So keep on clicking on that. And then finally, when you see that all the details, you will check it out. I have already mentioned all the details. And once you're satisfied, click on get subscription. And then you will see three types of subscriptions. Whatever you feel like, recommended one is there, definitely the 6 months. And don't forget to use the coupon code SWREPRO. Because if you do not use the coupon code, you will not be able to avail the discount price. All right. So as replay the video once again, I have already explained it. Okay. Hi, Advika. I'm not ignoring you. Okay. Moving ahead. Next is, okay, now we enter into the grammar part. Okay. So quickly tell me the answers because almost we have less time. So quickly tell me the grammar answers. Jaldi, quickly. Why worthless? Because worthless is not a bodily movement, and others, shaking, trembling, all of them were bodily movements. So that is what the question was asking. Okay. Okay. Hi, Harshil. Okay, D, C. Okay, let me quickly go to the answers itself because we are falling short of time. So the first answer is the Vangala is an important festival for the Garo in Meghalaya. etc. It is a post-harvest festival celebrated to mark the end of the agricultural year. Okay, and then during the signature dance, the leading warrior leads the youngsters. Okay, leads the youngsters with synchronized dance steps and specific hand head movement. All right. Any problem in the grammar portion? All the three answers are clear to you? Yes or no? All the three answers are fine with you? Or you have any doubts regarding these three options? Pakka, clear? No doubt? Pakka? Okay. Second question, which one? Okay, this one, it is a post-harvest festival. It should be celebrated to mark. Okay, celebrated to mark what? The end of the agricultural year. No doubts. Fine. Moving ahead is the, narration. Now, you have to fill in the blanks to complete Venu's narration. So, this is the picture which is given to you. Okay, so let us do this. See, I saw... Okay, this is for the visual, visually disabled. I saw Supandi standing in the field when I dash doing there. What should it be? Quickly. Ignite. When I asked him what he was doing here. Okay, when I asked him what he was doing there, fine? Okay, there is no, it's not exclaimed. He was just asking, right? Let me go back to this one. See, what are you doing here, right? So, he was just asking. Exclamation, there is no exclamation over here, okay? Then, he was trying to win a Nobel Prize. Okay, so he replied that he was trying to win a Nobel Prize. All right, moving ahead, I was confused and inquired how standing in the rice field would help him do so. He stumped me by saying that he won Nobel Prizes. He had heard that people who had heard that people who had, look at the other options. Has heard that people who has. People, with people you never have has. And it should not be has because it is in the present tense. So, simple present should be converted into its corresponding past tense. Remember the rule? So, it should be had. And the second problem is with people you never have has. People is plural. So, it should be had. Right? And this is, if it would have been have, then also, this would have been the correct answer because in narration, this is the rule that when you have simple present, any tense that is converted into its corresponding past tense. So, this is past, present perfect should be converted into past perfect. All right, clear? Is this clear, guys? Yes or no? Is this clear? Okay. So, that was all. I hope the grammar portion is clear to you. Hi, Amrita. Okay, is this clear? Okay, chalo. Let's move ahead. Now, you have to select the correct options. Now, let me go straight away to the answers. You need to consult the thesaurus if you need group of synonyms. You need to. That means there is a necessity. I told you this is pertaining to modals, right? So, you need to is the correct modal because need to is describing what? The necessity. Next is everybody dash keen to participate. Everybody with everybody subject verb agreement. According to that, you do not use plural. With everyone, everybody, these indefinite pronouns. Always with indefinite pronouns, you use the singular verb, right? According to the subject verb agreement rule. So, is would be the correct answer. The good news is that dash volunteers dropped out this month than the last two. So, see, you have a comparison, right? So, therefore, it should not be First of all, you know that less is used for uncountable, right? And few is used for countable. And here they have made a comparison. So because they have made a comparison, it should be fewer, right? Not few. All right, is this portion clear? Happy birthday, Miku. Okay, Amrita, all the best. Hi, Vidhu. Is this clear? The last one, question number 3, 7 part 3. Clear? Okay, fine, great. Next is, it was a historic day for the organization when an honor was bestowed upon its employees. Right? With historic, you have a, not an. Next. At this time, tomorrow, we dash our project details to ma'am. We shall be presenting. Because this is what? This is future tense. Okay? Future tense. So, it should be shall be presenting. Simple future. Okay? Next. Okay, and the next one, there is some discrepancy in the question itself. Because see, the Kodomo dragon dash follow its prey till it will eventually dies. So, if will eventually dies, this is not correct. So, there is a discrepancy in the question itself. I could see that, right? But still, if we try and solve, despite the discrepancy, out of the four, what I thought is, see, must, it cannot be must because it's must is, you know, where there is a necessity. Okay. And could refers to past ability. So there is no past ability mentioned over here. May is probability. So again, it's not in sync with the sentence. So the best option what I found is will. But since there is a discrepancy, so I am not very sure of this, honestly speaking. Hena? So anyways, moving ahead with the next one is the literature part. Okay, literature part. So the second question, as I told you, I will be doing this question when I will be doing that particular chapter. So that this one I have not solved yet. The first one, how did Peggy justify her cruel behavior towards Wanda? What do you think about this question? Anyone? Hi, Abhas. Of course, I do remember. Come on. Wanda is not yet taken. Okay. Let's see. All right. So she was finding excuses to justify her behavior towards Wanda. Now she said, now who was finding Peggy? Peggy was finding excuses to justify her behavior towards Wanda. She said that they could do nothing then as Wanda had already left. Okay, giving an excuse for her irrational conduct, she advocated that by asking Wanda about all her dresses, she had urged her to get good ideas for her drawing. So this is what she said, right? That if I had not made fun of Wanda about her dresses, then this idea of, you know, drawing or painting all these beautiful, all of these 100 dresses and the way and which resulted in winning the competition would not have occurred in her mind, right? So that is the correct answer. Moving ahead, the definition of courage for Mandela. And this, guys, this is a very important question. It can definitely appear in your final question paper as well. So please take a look at the answer. The definition of courage for Mandela was to win and attain victory over fear. For him, the absence of fear was not the meaning of being courageous. So it's not that when there is no fear in a person, he is courageous. Being courageous does not mean absence of fear. He considered men to be brave when they had courage, when they had the courage to conquer the fear. All right? So this is the answer. Okay, Techno Games has a very good answer for us. The excuse that Peggy thought up for her behavior was that she never called Wanda a foreigner. She never thought Wanda... Okay, fine. No, the question was How did Peggy justify her cruel behavior? So she justified by saying that if she had not made fun of Wanda regarding her dresses, then she would not have come up with the idea which finally resulted in her winning of the competition. That is the justification given. Okay. Next is these two chapters we are still left to do. So we will do it and then we will discuss along with that. Why was it important for Mrs. Pumphrey to be a little cruel in order to be kind towards Tricky? What do you think? Thank you, Tushar. Quickly tell me. Grammar section was easy. Okay, that's good. Of course, I will do. Don't worry. So, Mrs. Pumphrey over-pampered Tricky, which led to his being obese and even lose his appetite and become seriously ill, developing bouts of vomiting. Despite being warned by Mr. Herriot about reducing the extra snacks, maintaining a proper diet and giving him exercise, Mrs. Pumphrey failed to be strict enough to discipline Tricky, which finally landed him in the hospital. So if she would have been a little strict, then this would not have been the result. So finally, you can end by saying, it was therefore important for Mrs. Pumphrey to be a little cruel. Little cruel as to what? As to giving a proper diet and, you know, not being so lenient in giving everything that he was greedy, right? The only fault of Tricky was greed. Okay. So if Mrs. Pumphrey would have been a little strict there, a little cruel there, then she would have been actually kind in the real sense, because that would not have landed Tricky into the hospital, right? So this is the answer for that. I hope this is clear. Yes. Okay. Next is, Anne writes that it was fortunate that Mrs. Keesing took the joke the right way. Why does she feel so? What do you think? Why does she feel so? Quickly tell me. Hi, Prameet. She loves Tricky very much. Yes, of course. All right. So Anne felt lucky when Mr. Keesing took her poem in the right way. Mr. Keesing was annoyed. So why was he annoyed? Because of her constantly chattering, right? So she also called her, he also called her chatterbox. And then he gave her extra assignments on subjects like chatterbox and incorrigible chatterbox. So please mention the name of these assignments. Don't forget to mention, okay? And Anne was determined to put an end to it. So with the help of a friend, finally she came up with a poignant poem on that particular topic. What did she write? She wrote a satire that a father swan bit his three baby ducklings to death because of their noisy nature, because of their talkative nature, right? So please, you have to mention all the poems and what was the subject matter of Anne's poem, right? So mention the names of the assignments, names of the homework, and also subject matter or the content of Anne's poem, last poem, final poem, right? You have to mention these two points, guys, right? And finally, the professor took it lightly. The professor recited the entire poem in front of the class while giving his own remarks simultaneously. The author, being fortunate enough, talked uninterruptedly after this incident without any further homework. Also, Mr. Keesing, the professor, started cracking jokes every now and then in front of the class. So this is the answer for that. Alright, yes, that he is not going to give further assignments. Absolutely, Sashimul, absolutely. Hi, Ashita, I'm not ignoring you. Business letters. Beta, the syllabus which you have been given is, you could be given letter based on any situation. So formal letter based on any situation, right? That is the topic that you have been given. Okay, so next is, fire symbolizes desire. Okay, so that was the symbolic meaning. Fire symbolizes desire and ice symbolizes hatred. You know that desire is a kind of intense love or want that make people focusing on getting and possessing and acquiring. Our society is full of the people who spend lives craving for materialistic objects. this kind of desire can lead people to destruction. And Frost's poem speaks on this issue of greed corrupting the people and the society. The power of hate produces restrained devastation. How? For instance, you really can give examples that would definitely enhance your answer, right? How is hate, how do you think can hate lead to the end of the world? Hate, because could be the root cause of maybe racism, war, right? It can linger in a person's mind for lifetime, and it consumes the hater even more the person hated, right? And Nelson Mandela also said that when you hate someone, when you are prejudiced against someone, even the person who is, who is the oppressor, even he is not free, right? So same idea is here also, that even the hater is more consumed. So he is not only destroying the other person, he is at the same time destroying himself, his internal peace, his mental peace, right? So that, therefore, it is the cause of the ruin of the life of the people, and it would gradually lead to the end of the world, right? Same with desire as well. Is this paper difficult or not? That is for you to decide. You tell me. Okay, regarding the next answer which is from Amanda, okay, where she talks about Rapunzel. Okay, so why do you think is the allusion to Rapunzel given? Because yes, Amanda wanted to escape into a completely different world, because she was very tired of the nagging, of the constant shouts that her parents were doing. They were constantly trying to stifle her, right, and restrict her environment, and in the process what was happening was her development was getting hampered, right? So therefore she wanted freedom, and according to her, Rapunzel, she wanted to be like Rapunzel, because Rapunzel used to live in a tower, right? So she says she would live a peaceful life without the company of anybody else, and she would also not let down. She wanted to avoid the fate meted out to Rapunzel. Rapunzel had laid down her hair, and that is why her hair got chopped off, right? So she said that she would want to go undisturbed, right? And she would never let her hair down. She would not have meet the same fate as was meted out to Rapunzel. All right, so therefore the allusion to Rapunzel. Next is Griffin's brilliance as a man of science fades before his darker traits. This we had already done in the class itself. So basically you have to talk about how Griffin, being a man of science, being an intelligent man, being a good scientist, he could have used his inventions for the benefit of mankind. We have discussed this topic repeatedly in the classes. So that is itself the answer. But instead of that, what did he do? He used the formula for his own devilish activities. And you have to mention all the activities. So you can read through this and you can definitely take help from the answer. And then, talking about Ebright's social science teacher, of course, Mr. Weherer talked about how he used to be very much devoted not only in his scientific research, but also in debate, where he used to devote extra hours for research on the topic of debate, right? So, and he also explained that Richard was interested in winning because he wanted to win. It is because he wanted to do the best, right? And he wants that for the right reasons, not like Griffin's. Okay, so that is the answer. Hi Jessica, hi Priya, thank you Kajal, hi Benita, hi Aisha, hi Priya. Okay, so I hope you are getting all the answers. I hope there is no doubt, at least in the literature portion and the grammar portion. How can we write headings for these answers? But the headings you don't need to write. Just give the introductory line, and in a paragraph you need to write. All right. Okay. So the necklace. Okay. What was the question for necklace? What Madame Forestier exclaimed. What did Madame Forestier, I guess, exclaim in astonishment. Okay. So finally, this is the ending of the story. So please do take care of the ending of the story, right? So what had happened to Matilda was that she had completely lost all her beauty because she had to do all the heavy household work, right? And her softness, she had gained that hardness, her hands became hard, and finally she was a completely altered person, and even her friend could not recognize her, and she was astonished to see the changed person and cried, saying that she had completely changed, right? Crystal clear. Okay, Devika, that is good. Ritik, how to score? I think I have shared with you various videos like preparation strategies, how to score good marks. And now please watch those videos. They will be really helpful to you. Okay, next is, okay, these answers I have not written. I would explain you exactly what to write, because this is completely not based on the text, but this is based on your understanding. So whatever you write is absolutely correct. It's just that you have to justify your point. Okay. So this should come out from you, not me. Okay. So what is the question? Read the extracts given below and comment on the difference in the nature of health both the characters of these two stories received. So what do you think? What is the difference in the nature of the both the characters? First is from the black aeroplane. So the narrator from the black aeroplane, he received the help from from the pilot of a strange black aeroplane, right? And the next character is Lencho, who received help from the postmaster. So what do you think? What is the difference in the nature of the help? So that is for you to answer. So this is your homework, guys. And I will take up all your comments from this, and I will discuss this in the next section. Okay? How to improve vocabulary? This also I said that you need to... What you need to do is you need to read more and find out the meaning, the unknown words. At least collect two or three words each day with their meaning, with the synonym. And that would make a great stock of words, right? So that would be helpful. So please, please, please comment the homework answer in the comment section, right? So please, I want to see, and I will take your comments from here in the next session, all right? Next is, again, this one also, same for this. This is also homework, okay? Hari Singh says he knew it, but neither his lips nor his eyes showed anything. Anil successfully addressed the situation by not addressing it at all. Elaborate this on the reading of the story, the thief story. So this we have discussed in class a lot of time, maybe in a different manner, in a different way of presentation. But the answer is almost same, just the language has been altered, right? So I want you to, in the comment section, what is your homework for now? These two questions and finding out the word meanings of those words where I told you to do that, right? So please do comment these homework answers in the comment section. Don't forget, I will take up some of your comments, okay? What happened? One second. Sorry, I think there was some issue. 1 second, guys. Okay, yeah. So that was all, guys, for today, right? So before moving ahead, calling it a day, don't forget to visit the description box, link in the description box, and these are the options, right? And you can select any one. Three types of subscription are there. You can select any one, but of course, I would recommend you to select the 6-month subscription, guys. Okay? Don't forget to, there is a mistake in the code. It should be SWREPRO, guys. Don't forget that. For the English channel, there is a different code, okay? SWREPRO. And don't forget to use this in order to avail the discount price. All right, guys, which questions which I have already mentioned, please do replay the video and see. The last two questions, okay? This question, this one, 13th, and these two. I mean this one. There is only one question here. This one and this one. These are your homework question, and one more question was there from the extract based question where I told you to find out the word meanings. Okay? And make sentences. That is a good exercise for your vocabulary. So guys, before you go away, before you leave the class, don't forget to hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe if you still haven't subscribed. We need your support in this channel as well, right? So don't forget to hit the like button, share the videos with your friends so that they can also be, they can also solve the sample paper and, you know, enjoy the benefit, right? So thank you so much. Take care. Bye-bye. See you again in the next session, and where I'm going to take your comments and whatever doubts you still have and you think that there is still some doubt regarding whatever solutions I have given. So please don't forget to mention that in the comment section as well, right? And rhyme scheme, that answer also I will be taking up in the next session. So don't worry about that. Till then, take care. Bye-bye. See you again in the next session.